For people living in rural Ghana, it can be very difficult to access healthcare. There's a number of reasons for this. One is that healthcare facilities are sparse, and it may be too distant for people to get to hospitals or to find a doctor. The second reason is that they often don't understand what facilities are available, even if they can get to them. And the third thing is the cost of healthcare. Healthcare costs money. Now, people can have national health insurance, which provides many healthcare facilities free, but this costs 16 Ghana cedis per adult and 4 for a child. For a large family, this may exceed the annual income of a subsistence farmer, so it may be simply out of reach financially.
We're stood in front of Ashanti Development's clinic in Jatiyaza. When we come out here, we provide clinics here, and people from this village and the surrounding village can come and be seen. We also do outreach clinics to other surrounding villages. During those times here, with outreach clinics, we essentially provide primary care service, which is mainly identifying patients with problems and directing them to the correct pathways for onward care. In some situations we are able to provide care there and then, for instance, for malaria in young children with fevers, but we're very clear about where they seek onward care if they remain poorly. So we provide screening services for blood pressure and diabetes, long-term conditions. And we also pick up patients with eye problems, as this clinic is hoping to specialise in eye problems. The other arm that we're doing is prevention, and we have been doing a lot of education about malaria and how it is caught. And with that, how we are delivering that is by going out to the houses and identifying pregnant ladies and those with children under the age of one, and supplying them and putting up mosquito nets. We've identified these patients as these people as particularly at risk of getting malaria, which is why we're offering them nets. As part of the package, we're also providing education at the time about the importance of malaria and what they can do to reduce the risk in their local communities. Mosquito bites someone who is well. This is why we get the cycle of malaria.
We have three ways of breaking this cycle. And if there is any litter that collects water, yep, you should get rid of that. Secondly, if we become unwell, we should get early treatment. So if a mosquito bites us, the mosquito doesn't get malaria. And thirdly, we should stop mosquitoes biting us. The mosquitoes usually bite in the evenings or overnight.
Mm.
So that's why we recommend that people sleep under bed nets.
With regard to the mosquito nets and malaria prevention, we've gone out to the villages and explained the reasons why we're offering mosquito nets to them. And when we've explained that, they've been very pleased to have them put up for them. We've actually had an opportunity to go back 18 months later, and not only has there been good compliance with continuing to use the mosquito nets, but the villagers have also reported that they think malaria rates have gone down.
We believe it's very helpful for the people here to have healthcare workers like ourselves visiting when they don't otherwise see other healthcare workers. For us, it's also very rewarding, but we're only able to come here for a few weeks a year, and it would clearly be of great benefit if there were other healthcare workers who could come to villages like this and provide care for people who badly need it. Machozi ya dunia. Unisalimie nyasi, unisalimie kabila. Pale tulipofika, kulikuwa tunaenda, tulipata shida, tulipata mateso.
Salimia.